I was in the lucky position that I spent an evening with Sean Ryder about 2 months ago.
Wow.
I mean 200 other people, you know, in theatre.
I spent an evening.
It's called An Evening with Sean Ryder.
It's showtime, folks.
Everyone, and welcome to another episode of Into the Music. My name is Greg, and that guy over there is John. John, how are you doing today?
Hallelujah! I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing great too. Maybe not as good as you, but yeah, I'm doing okay. Great. So, but yeah, I'll have what you're drinking. And if you can't give me that, give me a song. Give me a song that's going to make me feel somewhat like that. You got one?
I've got just the ticket for you. Band is a band called Black Grape. Have you heard of Black Grape?
Yes. Recently I have. Since doing this channel, yeah. Some people have dropped that name, but I haven't really gotten to into their music. I've been sort of, I guess I've been waiting, you know?
You've been sitting at the sidelines coquettishly, fluttering your fan, waiting for the right person to ask you to dance. Well, now's your time.
Are you asking me? Are you?
You asking? You dancing?
Yes, you dance.
Yeah, the record is the Reverend Black Ray.
No. Cool.
Well, load up, go away, and enjoy. Yeah!
Already a chill groove. Oh man. Bass. Loving this already.
Black people, will I deliver this message? Kill the message. You do nothing but socialize and become a menace. Put on your Reebok, man, and go play fucking tennis. Can I get a witness? I said, can I get a witness? Okay,
alright, just couple things, and I'll try to just shut up and leave it to the end. But you know, it has that Happy Mondays sound feel, but then he's and voice, and what's his name, Sean Ryder, but I mean, it sounds like him. This is not him, right, in this group. But then he's like, can I get a witness? And there's that James Brown, there's that funk feel, you know, and even in the sort of in the soul and emotion of the voice, the vocals, can I get a witness? And that's James Brown, right? Is this like sort of a homage to him? I don't know. All right, I'll try to shut up the rest of the way. I can't promise anything.
Clean up.
whole sound. Drop. And when I said that was enough, like, I mean, I could have gone on more, but okay, 517. I mean, how much more do you want? I want more. All right, that's so good. So good. Okay. I mean, it sounds like Sean from Happy Mondays. His last name's Ryder, right? I might get that wrong, but not only his voice, but just the sound, the overall sound of the band. Wow. Okay. I'm so intrigued. And I can't wait to talk about this with John. Oh, man, that was great. That was a trip, man. So let me ask you, is that Sean Ryder from Happy Mondays?
It is indeed. Sean yeah. William Ryder.
So how many people in this band right now are from Happy Mondays? Because it's not just his voice that was like, oh, my God, Happy Mondays. It was also, as the song's going on, it was the music. I'm like, this is like a Happy Mondays feel, a vibe, a sound.
Kind of. Yeah, just one. And that's Bez. And he's the one who dances. So all the lyrics, all the music, Sean Ryder.
Wow. Really? Wait, yeah. So Sean does more than sing, right? He play, what does he play?
I don't know what he plays on this, but he wrote the music and the lyrics.
That's crazy.
And got the band in. I've got the members of the band, actually. So there's obviously Sean on vocals, guy called Ged on drums, guy called Wags on guitar, and a guy called Ollie Dirty Cash on ocarina, which is like, whoa, noise as well. And Kermit is the other guy rapping with it.
Is this band after Happy Mondays?
Yes, this is basically what Sean did next after the Happy Mondays imploded.
All right. He's a genius then, because this is like a happy, and that's fine. It's like, well, they have their own sound. No, absolutely. But there was a feel. There was this feel, a Happy Mondays feel, that Sean was able to, in the music that he created, like to get these guys, you know, like if he's just singing on this, but to basically absorb and almost reincarnate, you know, that Happy Monday sound through that. And that's a good thing, because Happy Mondays was fantastic. I loved their sound. And on this, it was that funk kind of sound, but there was also like more of a rock sound to this too. And it was the wah-wah. The wah-wah just kept coming in and kept coming in, but it was kind of, it kept coming in, but it was sneaky. It would come in here and then it was here. And it was like inventive, you know, you were hearing the wah-wah kind of, and then it was like wah-wah-wah, you know, over here. It was really, oh my God, it was so good. The bass was amazing.
Yeah, yeah.
The bass sounded like the Happy Monday bass.
Yeah.
And it was really interesting is that he's singing and then he's like, can I get a witness? And it's funny because when he started singing, there was like a sort of James Brown feel to his voice. And then that was before he sang this line. And then he sings this line, can I get a witness? And I'm like, I even stopped it. I'm like, this is like homage to James Brown, you know, because he had that famous song, can I get a witness, you know? And so is there like a connection there that were they doing this song really in tribute to James Brown?
Not this particular song, but I will say this. I was in the lucky position that I spent an evening with Sean Ryder about 2 months ago.
Wow.
I mean 200 other people, you know, in theater.
I spent an evening.
It's called An Evening with Sean Ryder. I have to say, I mean, we were like four rows from the front. And, you know, he's not in the, you know, first flushes of youth anymore, but he looks okay. He did say he was waiting for his hip replacement, which isn't particularly rock and roll, but he said I'm still alive, which is the main thing, you know.
Yeah.
And he talks about his career, he talked about Happy Mondays growing up and what he did, and he was a scally, you know, the things he got up to, I won't repeat half of them, but it was really entertaining. I haven't laughed so much outside of a comedy show in a long time.
Oh, that's so great.
And yeah, he was hilarious, and he was very warm. And, you know, he was himself, but, you know, he was giving and talked a lot. So he talked about the end of the Happy Mondays and all these myths about it. And he was saying that they're all imploding. The keyboard player thought he was the big shot in the band and Bears was out of control. He was out of control. He said he was, you know, and they all were. So they all exploded. And then he put this band together. And he had a vision. And the vision was he wanted it to be a cross between the Rolling Stones and Cypress Hill. That's what his vision was. And so he had that sort of funk and rock and roll. But he also talked about when they were forming Happy Mondays. Back then, I don't think it was the same in the States, but in late 70s Britain, he said music was tribal. And you were part of a gang or a tribe and you liked ska, so you didn't like funk. And you liked disco, so you didn't like punk. I'm a poet, didn't know it, but he said, but then him and his mates, they were like, sod it, we like everything. And they would listen to James Brown and they would listen to the Stooges and they would listen to Bowie, and he worshipped Bowie, by the way, so you know, and they would listen to the Pistols, but they would also listen to, you know, all sorts
drawn,
of stuff,
drawn influences,
and that's what they always try to put together. And that's what their aim was in Happy Mondays. And obviously certain things will come to the front, which is their style and trademark, but he has got a certain type of ear for music, and that's what drives it with Happy Mondays, and particularly in Black Grape. And he's come up with Winner Winner Chicken Dinner with this. I think this first album in particular is just, I mean, the album itself came out 95, straight in number one. Within a year, it was platinum. You know, wow, he hit big time. And probably more success than he ever had with Happy Mondays for just one single record, you know.
They only put one album out?
They put three albums out.
Three, okay.
So they did this album. They did a follow-up album 2 years later called Stupid, Stupid, Stupid. It's not quite as good, but it's fun, you know. And then again, they imploded. He sacked them all one night, you know, they all sort of, you know. But they got together in 2010 for a one-off gig. And he said it seemed to feel all right. So, I mean, they never rushed these things. So 5 years later, they got together again in 2015. And it was for a benefit gig because Bez, you know, his mate who dances, was running to be a member of Parliament.
Wow.
And so they did a benefit gig to raise money for his, it was called the the reality party or something. And they had so much fun. They said, right, yeah, we're going back on the road. Bez stayed out of it. The rest of them carried on. And they put a new album out in, I think, 2017 called Pop Voodoo, which I actually haven't heard. So I don't know. You know, some things I think it's the best. It's probably okay. I'll probably have to, you know, check it out. But, you know, they're a really fun band. And I think the sort of, you know, injection of Kermit, the guy who's rapping with him, brings a different dynamic. And he has something to bounce off and trade within the song, you know, rather than such as himself. And, you know, the guy's going, hell yeah, and all this sort of thing. You know, it's, I think it's brilliant. It's a great, great song. You know?
And who's playing guitar?
It's a guy called Wags. I haven't got the full name because they've all got silly sort of, you know, nicknames.
Is it one guy or is it two guys? Because it sounded like there was a couple of guitars going on in the song.
There's one guy. So there were a lot of the members were from a band called the Ruthless Rap Assassins. So like three or four from, they were a group that never made it. But, you know, they were a local band. And he cherry picked them from it and formed, you know.
The guitar work was stellar.
Right.
It was loosey goosey, but it was on, and it was so, it really was. It was such a full sound too. How they played it, but they also, I think it was well produced too. It wasn't overproduced, but I mean, it was just, they were able to get everything just like, you know, tilting, like boom, like right at it. I loved it.
Oh, yeah. I forgot to say, just as a side sort of insult to everybody, this album that it comes from is a reference to his problems in the past and work. So it's called "It's Great When You're Straight." Yeah, you know. So again, that's, you know, that's him all over.
Right. Who is that on the album cover that I was staring at in the video? Do you know who that person is?
With the
black sunglasses.
I think it might be a sort of a morphing of him, Sean Ryder.
Wow. Okay. All right. And then the Black Grape. So, like, where did he get that name?
I do not know. If I had to guess, it's probably something to do with drugs. But I don't know.
Wow. Yeah.
Because it's been a big part of his life, you know, and he makes no bones about it. And he said for the most part, he really enjoyed it and never had any problems. So.
Oh, he enjoyed it. Right? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
Almost did him in. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Many times.
Yeah, he was on 60 Minutes, actually, about 15 years ago. Yeah, I think 15 years ago or so.
Back then, was he quite big? Because he had problems, I think, with his kidneys, and so he ballooned in weight, you know.
Yeah, it might have been. And it was a lot of, like, regret. And the drugs that he was taking and like that, and how great this band was, Happy Mondays. Yeah. And they were like on their way to superstardom and they just didn't quite get there. But the music they put out, I mean, Kinky Afro is one of my favorite all-time favorite songs. It's one of the songs, maybe within the first 50 or so that we did on this chat channel, maybe in the first couple of months, I gave that to Chris and Chris really liked it a lot. I love that song. It's so good. It's just balls out in your face, you know, love it. This is great.
There's another song off this album, which probably rivals that. It's better than this. So if you're very good, you might get it down the line. We'll see what Santa thinks at Christmas if you've been a good boy.
I can't promise. You know me, my attitude, you know.
But seriously, it's even better.
I can rub people the wrong way, you know, but I'll do my best. I'll try to be on my best behavior. Well, John, thanks a lot. And to everyone out there, what do you think about the song? What do you think? If you liked it, the reaction, you liked it, hit the like button, subscribe. That'd be great. Love to have you on board. And behave yourself. We'll see everyone of you on the next episode of Into the Music.
Bye.